Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Because ethers are fairly unreactive, they are often used as reaction solvents. In teaching organic chemistry, I tend to focus more on reagents and transformations. The solvent is a detail that I often skip because we can only handle so much information for each reaction. Solvents, however, are important. They are the medium in which our reaction occurs. A traditional time to consider solvents is when learning about ethers. On this slide, I have outlined 5 different solvent categories. We'll identify some solvents that fit each category and give examples of the types of reaction with which they are often used. In our first category, we have the ethers. There are many common ether solvents: diethyl ether, tetrahydrofuran or THF, and dimethoxyethane, DME, are among the classics. Ethers are unstable in strong acids, but they are very resistant to bases. They are used with LDA, enolates, organometallics like Grignard's, and lithium aluminum hydride. Our second category involves alcohols and water, including methanol, ethanol. These are polar protic solvents. Protic because they are hydrogen bond donors with the OH group. They are also weakly acidic. These solvents are often used anytime you are using less reactive reagents. Also, if you're talking a lot about the equilibrium of a reaction, one of these will likely be the solvent. The third category includes the polar aprotic solvents. That's dimethylsulfoxide, DMSO, and dimethylformamide, DMF, among others. These are widely used. We see them a lot in SN2 reactions. Their polarity helps to dissolve the nucleophilic salts found in SN2 reactions. The fourth category includes the halogenated solvents, like methylene chloride, also called dichloromethane or DCM, chloroform, and dichloroethane. These solvents resist acids and are often used for reactions that require very strong acids. The final category is the hydrocarbons, including hexane, benzene, and toluene. These are sometimes used in reactions like transition metal catalyzed couplings, which we'll see later in a later playlist. Hydrocarbons, however, are less common solvents for reactions. They are less reactive. They're often found in consumer products like markers and glues. That is a quick summary of solvents in organic chemistry. These solvents often appear under the reaction arrow, and we sometimes ignore them. Picking the right solvent, however, can make a big difference in the success of a reaction.